ministers and for all the sisters and my fellow Christian friends in Christ Jesus. My devotional thought, I really have to ask myself, what are my priorities as a Christian? What am I doing for my fellow man? And you should ask yourself, are you bold enough in Christ to go tell yourself that Jesus paid it all? And you should all ask all of yourself, what am I doing for that someone who's perished? And I'm in the marvelous life, and by God's grace, I'm here. But there's somebody that we were left with a charge to tell somebody that Jesus loves, that in spite of him, he loves. You know, we all should be able to do that. When we read it, we should be able to go to someone. And we all know it's somebody in our life. We may not go in a minute, but it's somebody. Somebody to tell that I love you. In the name of Jesus, I love you. Jesus loves you. You're not doing nothing too bad that he can't forgive you for. You know, and as Christians, in the Sunday school lesson, it was brought out in 1 Samuel chapter 6, verse 12. It said, fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, who quicken all things, and before Christ Jesus, who will go upon his Father, witness the good confession. That means that us, as Christians, ought to be able to make a good confession. We ought to be able to tell somebody that Jesus is the way, he's the truth and the life. Stand and tell them that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You know what? I'm going to try. You got to kill someone. And I'm not going to worry about it in the time of waiting. But just pray to think someday they'll hear. I'm troubled on my heart, but God will help me. God. You know, somebody's my life. For me, you need to be a big brother. He needs me to be a good husband. And he needs me to be a father. You need to be whatever you are, somebody. And don't work with God first. And if he'll work it out, nothing is impossible with God. Because he said it in his promise. He said it in his word. And I believe in his word. And I know that by his word that I can live on.